Praise the living God, dear hearts. Thank you for joining me again today on Holy Ghost Fire Talk. I am your host, Evangelist King, delivering pastor at House Shalom. You know, House Shalom, we simply building God a peaceful house for his glory. Now remember, who's God's house? Our body is God's house. Our body, his house, his temple, his tent, his building, his dwelling place. You know what, dear heart? I know you have been told that you are under construction, but according to the word of God, Jesus said, it is finished. So therefore, dear heart, we're not a building under construction because Jesus has finished the building. Glory to his holy name. Today, we continue the teacher series on the manifestation or proof of the Holy Spirit. And this is part 17. So if you miss parts 1 through 16, then you need to go to the website, thechildrenoflight.org/radio. And it will list all the other parts to this series. Also, remember Holy Ghost Fire Talk. I come on live on Mondays and Fridays at 12 noon Eastern Standard Time. And instructions in which you can tune in to hear the live broadcast is also found at thechildrenoflight.org/radio. You have the opportunity to listen to the live teaching on the radio web player, or you can call the number that is listed. So for that information, go to thechildrenoflight.org/radio. So this time, dear heart, our lesson is entitled Gifts of Healing. That is plural, gifts of healing. You know, this is the last of the power gifts. So you might not understand what I'm saying, so you need to go back to part one. You know, the first three gifts, they're known as the revelation gift, which we have covered. They always reveal something. That is the gift of the word of wisdom, the gift of the word of knowledge, and the discerning of spirit. So now this is the last of the power gifts. We already covered the gift of faith, the gift of working of miracles. So this is the gift of healing. So the power gift always do something. So there are 12 gifts or manifestations of the Holy Spirit, and we've been covering each, every one of them in category of three. So the first three, it reveals something. The second three, it does something. So the gifts, that's plural, of healing. So that tells you, just like there's many, many sicknesses, I think they put out, what was it, 39 strikes on Jesus' back. Well, then there are at least 39 diseases. So there are 39 healing. That's why I say the gifts of healing. You know, there's many different types of healing that the Holy Spirit would manifest himself. So 1 Corinthians 12, chapter verses 7 through 11 says, but the manifestation of the Spirit, see, the 12 gifts of the Holy Spirit, it's not a gift that we own or can claim. It's just merely the Holy Spirit manifestation. That's how he manifests himself. So it said, but the manifestation of the Spirit is given to every man to profit with them. For to one is given by the Spirit the word of wisdom, to another the word of knowledge by the same Spirit, to another faith by the same Spirit, to another the gifts of healing by the same Spirit, to another the working of miracles, excuse me, to another prophecy, to another discerning of spirits, to another diverse kinds of tongues, to another the interpretation of tongues. But all these work that one in the self same Spirit, dividing to every man severally as he will. So it's according to the will of the Holy Ghost, how he chooses to manifest himself and to whom he chose. You know, it's not a gift where we can turn off and on, off and on. It's the Holy Spirit manifestation. And he manifests himself as he will through whomever he chooses. The gift of healing, excuse me, are manifested for the supernatural healing of sickness and disease without any natural source or means. As I have mentioned, every one of these nine gifts of the Spirit, they are supernatural. They are not natural, they're supernatural. Some gifts are more spectacular in demonstration than others, but they all are supernatural. We may have some difficulty because of our limited knowledge in defining some of the other gifts, but I think we should have little difficulty defining these gifts, especially gifts of healing. Most of all, basically, understand the subject of healing. Healings were, of course, in prominence in Jesus' ministry as he walked on the earth. Jesus had a healing ministry. And he also gave authority to his disciples to heal the sick. Matthew 10, chapter, verse 8. Healing the sick is also included in the Great Commission. Remember, Mark chapter 16, verse 18. Now, the gifts of healing, it is not medical science. First, I want to emphasize the supernatural character of the gifts of healing. The gifts of healing have nothing to do with a medical science or human learning. Luke, who was a medical doctor, was with Paul on many of Paul's missionary journeys. Luke wrote the Acts of the Apostles as well as the book of the Bible that bears his name. Luke was with Paul when he was shipwrecked and they were on the island of Melita. Now, nothing at all is said to the fact that Luke ministered to the people on that island with his medical knowledge. But the father-in-law of the chief man of the island was sick. And Paul laid his hands on him, and the man was healed. He was healed by the supernatural power of God. Now, this was the gifts of healing in manifestation. Then the islanders brought the sick from all over the island, and Paul ministered to them, and they were all healed. Now, certainly I believe in medical science, and I thank God for medical science. And I thank God for what it can do and what it is doing. But I am certainly not opposed to doctors, because God works through the doctors. But some people confuse medical science with the gifts of healing. Prophet Hagin, that's where this teaching is coming from, the Holy Spirit through Prophet Hagin, whom he had received from a great man of God. He said, I heard someone say on the radio one time that the gifts of healing were what God had given doctors in medical science. But the gifts of healing are not doctors in medical science. If that is God's method of healing, then doctors ought not to charge anything. Medical treatment ought to be free, because the Bible says, freely you have received, freely you give. Matthew 10, chapter, verse 8. So, however, as anyone who has had any experience with doctors knows, medical treatment is not free. Also, if doctors and medical science were God's method of healing, medical treatment would always be free from errors. Doctors would make no mistake. However, we know that this is not true either. Doctors and medical science are natural means of healing. The gifts of healing and other methods of divine healing, they are supernatural. I would not speak despairingly about doctors, hospitals, and medical science because they do much good for humanity. Praise God, and I'm a witness for that. I thank God for the number of good their patients at heart and who minister to them with their natural human ability as a trained physician. But the healing that is supernatural doesn't come by diagnosis or by prescribing treatment. Divine healing comes by laying on of hands, anointing with oil, or sometimes just by speaking the word. Just to name a few examples from the word of how healing is ministered. I believe in natural healing, and I thank God for it. I think one of the greatest errors in medical science and one in which the greatest strides have been made is in the field of preventive medicine. But not only do I believe in natural healing, I also believe in supernatural or divine healing. Praise the living God. Gifts of healing, they are prominent in the New Testament. It will help us to understand the operation and the purpose of the gifts of healing by looking at some of their uses in the scriptures. We know, first of all, that the purpose of these gifts is to deliver the sick and to destroy the works of the devil in the human body. And the Bible is full of such examples. We have discussed the working of miracles and the fact that the working of miracles is more prominent in the Old Testament than in the New Testament. It is just the opposite with the gifts of healing. The gifts of healing are more prominent in the New Testament than they are in the Old Testament. In the New Testament, there aren't many records on the gift of the working of miracles in operation. There were a few instances in the ministry of Christ and less in the Acts of the Apostles. But in the New Testament, there are many examples of the gifts of healing in operation. And that was because of the various sicknesses and diseases in which Satan and his demon had brought upon the body of people. Jesus ministered as a man, anointed by the Holy Spirit. Remember that Jesus ministered as a mere man, anointed by the Holy Spirit. Jesus himself, not as the Son of God, but as a man anointed by the Holy Ghost. Jesus was just as much the Son of God when he was 25 as he was the Son of God when he was 33 years old. Yet at 25 years old, he had not healed a single person. Not one miracle or healing had been worked under his ministry prior to him receiving the anointing of the Holy Spirit at the age of 30. And Jesus was just as much the Son of God when he was 29 years old as he was when he was 30. Yet at the age of 29, not one single person was healed in his ministry, nor has he worked one miracle of healing. Even when Jesus was 30 years of age, on the day before Jesus was baptized by John in the River Jordan, and the Holy Spirit descended upon him to anoint him to minister, Jesus was just as much the Son of God as he was after his baptism. Yet, until Jesus was anointed by the Holy Spirit, he never healed a single person. Before Jesus was anointed by the Holy Spirit, there was no manifestation of the power of God operating in his ministry. It was only after the Holy Spirit descended upon him in the form of a dove in order to anoint him to minister, that the gifts of the Spirit began to manifest in his ministry. In fact, Jesus himself said, "The Father that dwell in me, he does the works." John 14, chapter verse 10. He never did claim to do them himself or on his own. He said, "My Father in me, he does the works." How did he do them? He did it through the power of the Holy Ghost. Just like with you and I, dear heart, we are not the one who does the work, but it's the Father through his Son, Jesus, by his Holy Spirit, does the works in us. It's not us. Jesus stood up and read his hometown town synagogue. He said in Luke 4th chapter verse 18, "With all boldness," he said, "the Spirit of the Lord is upon me because he had anointed me." Then Peter, preaching to Cornelius and his household, said, "How God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Ghost and with power, who went about doing good and healing all that were oppressed of the devil, for God was with him," Acts 10 chapter verse 38. Although Jesus had always been the Son of God, he never healed anyone until after he was anointed with the Holy Ghost and power. Praise the living God. This should prove conclusively that Jesus didn't heal the sick by some power that was inherent in him as the Son of God. The second person of the Trinity, whether he healed the sick just as anyone else called of God would minister to the sick today, by the anointing of the Holy Spirit, by the manifestation of these gifts of healing, and by the preaching of the Word of God. The Word of God tells us in the book of John that Christ had the Spirit without measure, John 3, verse 34. Therefore, we will see a full manifestation of spiritual gift operating in Jesus' ministry that we wouldn't see in anyone else's ministry, because as John 3, verses 34 inferred, Jesus had the Spirit without measure. Therefore, no other person has the Spirit without measure. Glory to his holy name. However, it seems to me that John 3rd chapter verse 34 infers that the entire body of Christ has the same measure of the Spirit collectively as Jesus had individually. And that's why we need each other. Therefore, just one person would not have the same measure of success in ministering even the gifts of healing that Jesus had in his earth walk, because he had the Spirit without measure. Having the Spirit without measure, Jesus would have the manifestation of all the gifts of the Spirit in his earth walk, except tongues and interpretation, which are exclusive to the dispensation of the church age, which Jesus ushered in. Of course, all the gifts of healing will be included in the spiritual gift, which were manifested in Jesus' ministry. The gifts of healing. I want to point out a few verses in 1 Corinthians chapter 12. In verse 9, 28, and 30, the gifts of healing are mentioned, and it reads, "To another, faith by the same Spirit; to another, gifts of healing by the same Spirit. And God set some in the church, first apostles, secondarily prophets, thirdly teachers, after that miracles, then gifts of healing, helps, governments, diversities of tongues. Have all the gifts of healing? Do all speak with tongues? do all interpret. Notice in verse 28, both the words gifts and healings are plural. And this is the way it should be listed in every one of the verses where there is, where this gift is mentioned. In the Greek, verse 28 is gifts of healings, helps, governments, diversities of tongues. And according to Divine Expository Dictionary of Biblical Word, the word healings is plural in the Greek in verses 9, 28, and 30. Notice that this is the only one of the spiritual gifts listed in 1 Corinthians 12 chapter that is in the plural, gifts of healings. All the other gifts of the Spirit are singular, except tongues, which will be covered in a later lesson. Why are they gifts of healings and not the gifts of healing? The Bible doesn't specifically say, but I have an opinion on which I believe is well founded as to why this is so. I don't think any of us could know for sure scripturally, because the scripture doesn't specify or specifically tell us. However, it may be that there are gifts of healings because there are different kinds of diseases, and one gift wouldn't heal every kind of disease. For example, Hagin said, I have noticed in my own ministry, as well as in the ministry of others who have these gifts of healing in operation in their lives and ministries, that when it comes to healings, in some areas I have more access than in other areas. Other ministers have concurred that this is also true in their ministries. For instance, other ministers have told him that there are certain kinds of diseases they seldom get people healed of in their ministry. And yet, when it comes to other diseases, nearly every person they pray for is healed. Of course, this is not to negate the fact that believers can be healed on their own faith in God's word. And yet, we must also recognize that there are those in the body of Christ who are endued with particular spiritual gifts, such as gifts of healings. For instance, Hagin said, in my own ministry, ruptures, growths, hernias, or lumps of any kind are almost always healed when he prayed for people. He said, I once kept a record in every meeting I pray for people. He said, I once kept a record. I had over a period of several years. He said, in 99 cases out of 100, these types of affliction were eventually all healed. Some of the growths disappear within a month. Others sometimes take several months before they completely disappear. But in most cases, the growths disappear and the people are healed. That is a manifestation of the gifts of healings. He also said one fellow who was greatly used of God in praying for people who were deaf said by his own administration that he very seldom got any other type of malady except deaf people. He said, I watched him several times in various meetings. He said, I never saw a deaf person fail to receive healing under this man's ministry. In the ministry of Jesus, every manner of sickness and every manner of disease was healed. Matthew 9, chapter verse 35. And that's because Jesus had the Spirit without measure. And all the gifts of healing were in manifestation in Jesus' life and in his ministry. So the Holy Spirit, as he will, he chooses to manifest himself in the gifts of healing. Now, one person, the Holy Ghost may manifest himself to heal people with cancer, to heal people with other diseases. I mean, it's all up to the Holy Ghost. You know, just because you see a man or woman of God and when they pray for you for a specific manner and you don't get healed, don't go out and say they're not a man or woman of God. Yes, they are. It's just that the Holy Spirit chose not to manifest himself in that area. That's why it's best to let the Holy Ghost tell us who to go to. So our problem is we have our favorite. We have our particular person to go to. But that might not be the one who the Holy Ghost has anointed and appointed in that area in setting you free. Because if it's being free from demon or being free from some kind of sickness or ailment. So it just pays us to trust the Holy Spirit in sending us to our human helper that he have chosen, not who we have chosen. You know, my grandmother coming up, again, she served God the best she knew how. But I noticed something as about her when I was a little girl. She had the gift of healing. I watched her. Anything that, first of all, let me rewind back. Her testimony was something got wrong with her leg one day. And she was tight, just did not go to a doctor. Now you gone to the doctor. But she just didn't go to the doctor. She was adamant against doctors. And so she said her leg got so bad, it got like it was gangrene. And she had her leg stretched out. She still wouldn't go to the doctor. And she said Oral Roberts was on television one day. And her leg was stretched out. And she said she was watching the program, Oral Roberts program. She said all of a sudden, it was as though someone started operating on her leg. It's like someone took a knife and cut it and it split open. And she said, all of this green stuff just pulled out of her leg. Just pulled out. And then she said, eventually she was healed. See, her leg was poisoned. Gangrene had poisoned her leg and she didn't even know it, but the grace of God. Through the man of God from television, watching his program on television, the anointing came forth into her leg. She was healed. Well, I believe it stemmed from that because I noticed with my grandmother, if we got sick, all she would say, go get the anointing oil, and she would apply to us, and we got healed. Anybody get sick, they come to my grandmother, she get the anointing oil and apply, they got healed. I'll even tell people, go to my grandmother, let her pray for you, you'll get healed. Because that was what I saw. She had the Holy Ghost manifest himself through her, through that gift. Praise the living God. Now, was she someone well known? No. That's how we miss it. We say, oh Lord, I want to go to this well known person. And you end up missing God because that's not who God chose. You see, God works with through those who know that there's nobody without him. Praise the living God. Gifts of healing versus receiving by faith. There's a difference between receiving healing through the manifestation of the gifts of healing and just simply receiving healing by our own faith in God's word. God has taught me through the years the difference between the two. Both are scripture ways to receive healing. You can receive healing by the gifts of healing or by faith in God's word. Hagin said, when I receive healing for my own body, for example, he said, no one lay hands on me. In fact, he said, I didn't really know there was any church group that believe in divine healing. I didn't know there was such a thing as a full gospel movement at that time. But he said, as a Baptist boy on the bed of sickness, He said, I read Grandma's Methodist Bible and I was healed, not just because I believe in divine healing necessarily, but because I act on and stood on Mark chapter 11, verse 24, which say, what things soever you desire, when you pray, believe that you receive them and you shall have them. So he said, I prayed and began to say, I believe I receive healing for my deformed heart. I believe I receive healing for my paralyzed body. I believe I receive healing from the top of my head to the soles of my feet. And God's healing power was manifested in my body. He said, my healing came because I act in faith on God's word. You can do the same thing. God's word will work for you if you believe and act on it. That's how I was healed. I act on God's word. I believe in his word. No one came and laid hands on me for me to be healed. I act on his word. I believe his word. I spoke his word. I spoke my health, and God healed me. You know, there's one thing that God told me during the time of my sickness. He said, Terry, I'm going to give you your youth back. I said, you are? He said, yeah, I'm going to give you your youth back. Daryl, he have done that. You know, I got a message on one of my videos. This young lady said, Evangelist King, you look so young, more younger than when I first came across your video 3 years ago. That's right. God gave me my youth back. Ain't he good, Daryl? You know, I got 60 more years to go. I'm going to live to be 120 years old. And I told the Lord, that's if I don't change my mind. I told the Lord that. I said, if I don't change my mind, I'll be ready to go where he is. Yeah. You don't have to stop at 70. We promised at least 120 years. Mm-hmm. So the Lord had to give me my youth back in order so I could make it another 60 years. If by faith. God is so good. You sit down and believe you're going to die at a certain age. Why can't you believe you'll live for his glory? We got a lot of work to do for the Lord. So God's word will work for us if we believe and we act on his word. Gifts of healing are manifested through another person to you. See, gifts of healing is manifested through another person to you. That's the laying on of hands. All healings, they are done by God. But the difference is in the channel in which God used. The channel through which healing is manifested. Someone has said that anytime you receive healing, it is done by the gifts of healing in operation. And that's not true. In one sense, the word gift, healing by any method, is a gift because anything you get from God is a gift, generally speaking. So anything God gives us, it's a gift. We've done nothing to deserve it. It's just a mere gift. However, all healing is not necessarily the gift of healing in manifestation. Hagin said, my own healing, for example, was manifested as I believe God's word and act on it in faith. Same with my healing. That's why the doctors, they really, even to this day, I went to my cardiologist yesterday, and he's still in shock. You know, he tried to make up something for me to do, and I looked at him. He said, well, I guess there's nothing wrong. Don't try to mess it up. I said, that's right. You know, he's still in shock, dear heart. But a lot of times, we can receive our healing simply by faith in God's word. But that's a different method. See, the Lord told me years ago, he said, I would change the method. That's why you don't never get hooked on a specific method, because God will change it. Because you do have some people, like I was, who was sick, and you don't know anybody, a non-appointed person come lay hands on you. So you better receive by faith in God's word that he heals, he delivers. Ministering by the gifts of healing. Look again in 1 Corinthians 12, chapter verse 28, say, and God has set some in the church. Paul was not talking here about spiritual gifts or the gifts of the Spirit when he said, God has set some in the church. He was talking about men and women who were equipped with spiritual gifts and ministries. The sum that was set in the church includes first apostles. 1 Corinthians 12, verse 28. Apostles isn't an individual gift that someone might receive. It is a ministry gift to the church. Some also include secondary prophets. 1 Corinthians 12, verse 28. That is a ministry, not to bless an individual, but it is a ministry that is given to bless the whole church, the body of Christ. 1 Corinthians 12, chapter verse 28 says, thirdly, teachers. The teaching gift is not something that is given to bless one who ministers in that anointing. It is a gift that is given to enable a person to bless others. It is a ministry gift to the body of Christ. Paul went on in this passage to talk about the working of miracles. After that, miracles, 1 Corinthians 12, chapter verse 28. He was saying that there are some people in the ministry who are equipped with the working of miracles in their ministry. That verse continues, then gifts of healing, 1 Corinthians 12, chapter verse 28. Then Paul asked the question, are all apostles? 1 Corinthians 12, chapter verse 29. In other words, Paul was saying, does everyone have the ministry of an apostle? The answer is no. Then he said, are all prophets? No. Are all teachers? The answer is no. Not everyone has the ministry of a teacher to the body of Christ. Certainly, we could all teach to the extent of our knowledge, but that's not the ministry gift of the teacher. There are those whom God has put in the church who are equipped by the Holy Spirit with a teaching gift. Hagin said, I wasn't always a teacher. In fact, for the first 9 years of my ministry, I was strictly a preacher. He said, I like to preach. I was a sermonizer, and I had received a great heritage and background along this line from the Southern Baptists. He said, I could read Spurgeon's sermons and preach them just as he did. He said, I love to preach, but I did not like to teach. He said, in my pastoral work, it was customary many times for me as a pastor to teach the Sunday school class in the main auditorium, which was attended by about 35-year-olds and older. He said, I didn't like that. He said, sometimes I would wait until Sunday morning to prepare for it because I knew I could read the lesson and get up and recite it without a lot of study. He said, I took time to prepare my sermons and get ready to preach for my church service, but I just didn't do that much about preparing them when it came to teaching. He said, I never was so glad about anything in my life when that Sunday morning ordeal was over. He said, but in May 1943, my mother was 3 years old, in the parsonage of the church that my wife and I pastored in Farmersville, Texas, God gave me a teaching gift. I knew what it was when it came. I didn't have it before, but I knew when I got it. I didn't have it before, he said. I knew when I got it. It was just as real to me in the spirit as it would have been in the natural realm if someone had handed me a $500 bill. Teaching is a ministry. It wasn't given to me for my individual benefit. It was not given to him to write books to make money off of. It was given to make me a blessing to others. The same is true of the working of miracles and the gifts of healing and all of the ministry gifts. As we have seen in 1 Corinthians 12, chapter verse 29, Paul asked, all apostles? Of course not. Are all teachers? The answer is no. Everyone doesn't have a teaching ministry. He said, I didn't for years. I would teach when I had to, but I didn't have that ministry. Then Paul asked, are all workers of miracles? Well, it is quite obvious that all are not workers of miracles. Then in verse 30, it says, have all the gifts of healing? No, all people do not have the gifts of healing. This scripture refutes the idea that if a person receives healing, he has also automatically received an impartation of the supernatural gifts of healing, a gift of the Spirit to minister healing to others. And this scripture refutes the idea that a person is necessarily always healed by gifts of healing. He could be healed on his own faith in God's word. So 1 Corinthians 12, chapter verse 28, isn't referring to a healing that is given to a person to bless them. It is a ministry of healing given to bless others. Any healing from God is a gift, of course. In fact, anything we receive from God, any blessing, would be a gift. But these gifts of the Spirit are supernatural manifestations of the Holy Spirit. And gifts of healing are one such operation manifested to someone through another. Gifts of healing are one way of receiving healing. But as I said, there are ways of receiving divine healing other than by the manifestation of the gifts of healing. Hagin also said, as a Baptist boy preacher, he said, I would preach on faith and prayer. He said, I wasn't conscious of any kind of anointing or any manifestation of the gifts of the Spirit in operation as I minister to people. He said, I would just pray for people in faith, and God would honor faith because God honors faith in his word. Therefore, people were healed. God always honors faith. He said, later I learned that there were others preaching divine healing besides him. They called themselves full gospel. He said, I would fellowship with them. And soon afterwards, he said, I got the baptism of the Holy Ghost and spoke with other tongues. He said, I continue to pray for the sick by the laying on of hand and by the anointing with oil. He said, in 1938, he said, I accepted the pastorate of a little full gospel church in the backland of North Central Texas. He said, while in prayer late one night, the Lord said to him through the Spirit, I have given thee gifts of healing and have sent you to minister to the sick. You'll pray that the Lord will speak to you your divine purpose for him. He said, as a pastor, I have been anointing people with oil and praying for them in faith for healing by the laying on of hands. He said, up to that time, there had been no manifestation of the gifts of healing through me. He said, many times people would be healed because they got in agreement with me and we were acting in faith on God's word. But after the Lord spoke to me concerning my ministry to the sick, he said, I became conscious of this other something working in my ministry, and there would be a manifestation to other people through me. And I really didn't do anything about it except to yield to the Holy Ghost. Then I saw the difference between healing by simply believing God's promises and by the operation of the gifts of healing. People can be healed directly by believing God for themselves. Many are healed as I was simply by believing God. But when it comes to the gifts of healing, there is a special manifestation of the Spirit through one person to another who is in need. When people ask me to minister to them, Hagin said, all I can say is that I will minister to them with all the ability I have, with all that God has given me. But he said, but we don't operate the gifts of the Spirit as we will. It is as the Holy Spirit wills. However, if there is no gift of the Spirit in manifestation, people can always be healed and set free based on the word of God. The Bible says it is the anointing or the power of God that destroys the yoke. Isaiah 10 chapter verse 27. The anointing is on the word of God. The anointing is on the word of God. So we need to speak the word of God. That's why it's so important for believers to be members of a local body, a local church, where the word of God is preached and where God moves by his Spirit. Also, he said, I have found that when the Spirit of God is moving, it is a whole lot easier to receive whatever it is you need from God than it is at any other time. However, that still does not eliminate receiving healing on your own by simply believing God's word. Because the Bible says, by whose Jesus stripes, ye were healed. 1 Peter 2 chapter verse 24. Thank God, dear heart, for his word and for the privilege of believing and acting upon his word. Thank God, too, for supernatural manifestation and for the gifts of healing, because you know, we need the Holy Ghost to manifest himself in our day and time now, because I'm observing the devil and his disease of cancer. I never heard so many people that is having, God's children having cancer. Cancer is a demonic spirit, the demonic spirit. So we need a manifestation of the Holy Ghost in the gifts of healing. Come against that cancer spirit in Jesus' mighty name. Glory to his holy name. I thank God for his word. That concludes it. So the next one is part 18, and we're going to cover the gift of prophecy. Amen. All right, dear heart. So now remember to tune in to Holy Ghost Fire Talk on Monday and Friday at 12 noon Eastern Standard Time. It's the live broadcast. It's best to always refer to the website, thechildrensmite.org/radio, where you can tune in. You can tune in and listen on the web player on the radio, or you can call that listener number. There's a listener number there which you can call, but you have to go to thechildrensmite.org/radio. Praise the living God. Now I thank God for his word. The Holy Ghost, as I was sharing God's word, he was just, that fire was burning on the inside of me. I just thank God. Dear heart, protect your faith in God. Let me advise you. You on Facebook, and the post is coming across your eye, because whatever your eyes is reading is going into your hearing. You ever notice that when you read, it's going into your hearing? You thought whenever you people say something, then that's when you hear. But you read, it's going into your hearing. If you have people who is not sharing faith in God's word, that post is not building your faith in God's word, you really need to deactivate that account. You need to deactivate. Get off Facebook. Same thing with YouTube as well. If you can't stick to going to channels where your faith in God has been fed, but you found yourself, drawn off onto another path, then you need to get away from YouTube. Just get in the word of God to feed your faith. That's how you starve your doubt. Because faith is hard to find. And the media is making it very easy for Satan to call the poor God children from believing God's word, because the media shares lies and you believe everything the media tells you. Your heart, you know, the manifestations of the Holy Spirit can only operate in our lives through and by faith in God's word. If we don't have faith in God's word, then the Holy Ghost cannot manifest through us. Okay? Praise the living God. So, all right, dear heart, so tune in again on Monday, 12 noon Eastern Standard Time. Go to the website, thetreasuremite.org/radio, to find details on how to tune into this live broadcast. So, dear heart, you stay blessed in Jesus' mighty name. Shalom.